Hey guys, welcome to my channel and thank you so much for stopping by. So I am here today with a beautiful party or wedding guest makeup tutorial, and for today's look I have created this beautiful olive or khaki green smoky eye look, and I paired it with a beautiful like reddish warm lipstick. And you can pair this look with your black outfits, with your white outfits. This can be a beautiful wedding guest makeup look as well. So yeah, before starting, if you are new to the channel and if you are watching this face for the first time, then hi, I am Neeta. I upload makeup, skincare and beauty related videos here on my channel. If those things interest you, then please consider subscribing. And if you are already a subscriber, then thank you so much from the bottom of my heart. So yeah, without further blabbering, let's get started. Today I'm starting with my base, and for that I'm taking my Wet n Wild Photo Focus Primer Serum, and you can see I'm already out of it because I love it so much. It just gives me that extra boost of hydration and a little bit of tackiness, and it's just perfect for my dry skin, and I use it so much. For color correcting, I'm taking my LA Girl Pro Conceal Orange and Yellow color correctors, and I have taken 3 parts of the yellow color corrector and 1 part of the orange one. And I have mixed them to create my custom shade, and I am applying it underneath my eyes, around my mouth, and wherever I have pigmentation, dark spots and acne spots. I have really deeper darker under eye areas, so a color corrector is a must for me. I cannot skip it. If I do, then my concealer, my foundation, they just tend to look a little bit ashy, and I don't like that. For my foundation today, I am using my Maybelline Superstay Full Coverage Foundation in the shade 310 Sun Beige, and I'm just buffing it in using a damp beauty sponge. This particular sponge is from Wet n Wild, and if you follow me on Instagram and if you have seen my Insta stories, you must know I recently went to a beach holiday. I was chilling on a beach and I am a little bit tanned right now, so this foundation might seem a little bit lighter, but I will fix it with cream contour. For cream contour today, I am using my Merit Beauty Contour Stick in the shade Cacao. I got this particular product in PR, and this is how it looks like. I love the packaging, I love the shade, and I have been using this product a lot lately. This is a cruelty-free, vegan and clean beauty brand on Sephora. And I love the shade, it's just perfection for me. It's very creamy, it blends beautifully, it does not remove the product underneath, and it just gives me that beautiful like contoured effect, which I absolutely love. And I'm using this brush again from Merit Beauty, and I got it again in PR, but all the opinions are mine and mine alone. I love the brush, it's so soft, and it just blends my foundation, my concealer, my cream blush, my cream contour beautifully. You can see it's happening right here on camera and how beautifully the product is blending. Despite being such a darker, deeper shade, it just blended out beautifully. And this product is very, very creamy. It's not like Huda Beauty Tantor, which is a cream to powder formula. I would rather say it's a creamy matte formula, and I absolutely love it. And this brush is everything. It's actually a 2021 Allure Beauty Award winner, so it's a must have. For highlighting and concealing, I'm using my Milani concealer in the shade 135, and I'm applying it underneath my eyes, on my chin, on my cupid bow, around my mouth, on the center of my forehead, and down the bridge of my nose. I'm also applying it on my eyelids to prime my eyelids for eyeshadows, and then I'm blending everything out using a damp beauty sponge. This particular sponge is from Wet n Wild, and I love this concealer. It just gives me full coverage, it does not cake up or crease, it lasts all day long, and in short, this is one of the best drugstore concealers I have ever used. Now I'm just setting my under eye concealer as well as my smile lines using my Wet n Wild Photo Focus Loose Setting Powder in the shade Translucent. To set my entire makeup in place, I'm taking my Maybelline Superstay powder foundation, and I am just setting my entire makeup in place. Now I'm going to do my eye makeup, and for that first I'm taking this Brow Coat USA eyebrow pomade in the shade Deep Brown. Again, I got this product in PR and I absolutely love it. Though I received in this product in PR, you guys probably know I won't recommend you a product that I do not like. I really do like it. It's creamy, and I have been using it for over 1 year and it did not dry out on me. This formula is worth it. Absolutely recommend it. For my eyes, first I'm taking Pickle from my Beauty Bay Arthi eyeshadow palette. This is a beautiful olive green shade and I am applying it as my transition color with this large fluffy blending brush from Morphe. And I am slowly building it up to avoid any kind of patchiness, because with this kind of shades they tend to become really patchy, and I am using back and forth motion as well as circular motion here. Taking the same shade on a detailed blending brush again from Morphe, this is the Morphe M514 brush. I am concentrating it on my crease just to give my crease a little bit of depth. Don't worry if it is looking a little bit harsh right now, but I will blend it out later. Now I am taking the shade called Hero or Hard, I think it's hard. This is a beautiful like mossy greenish brown shade, such an interesting shade, and I am mainly focusing it on my outer V area and I'm dragging it slightly through my crease. For my lid shade, I am taking Folklore, though it's looking kind of bronzy shade on the pan, but it is a beautiful shimmery olive green shade, and I am applying it all over on my eyelid, and this is my Morphe M124 brush. You can see I am applying the shade like dry, it's not even wet and it's looking perfect. I love this eyeshadow palette. Then I decided to take a matte black eyeshadow from a different palette, because this palette doesn't have any black eyeshadow. So I decided to take a black eyeshadow and I decided to apply it right here on my outer V area just to give it a little more smokiness. Now I am taking my Flower Beauty Warrior Liquid Glitter Eyeshadow in the shade Camo. This is a beautiful like olive khaki green glitter shade. You can totally skip this step if you want to, but I had this product in my collection, so I just decided to use it and I absolutely loved it. Now I am going with my Maybelline Lasting Drama Gel Eyeliner in the shade Blackest Black, and I am lining my lid. It doesn't have to be perfect because I am going to smudge it anyway, so I'm just creating a rough wing here. Taking that matte black eyeshadow from the other palette that I used, I am smudging out this eyeliner just to give it a nice and smoky look. Smoked out eyeliners, it's very much in trend right now and I love it. For my lower lash line, first I'm just tight lining my eyes using my Milani eyeliner pencil in the shade After Dark. This is basically a matte black eyeliner. Now taking that shade called Hard, I'm smudging out my entire lower lash line. Taking the first shade, that was Pickle, I am smudging out the border of the previous shade just to tie the look together. And now I'm highlighting my brow bones as well as my inner corners using my Maybelline highlighter in the shade Molten Gold. I'm curling my lashes and I'm applying a coat of mascara. This is my Essence Lash Princess Volume Mascara. I will be using falsies off camera, of course. For that, I will be using my pink Zio lashes in the style Lady on Fire. I have a code with them. If you use my code, you can get 30% off. I will link it in the description box down below. And here is the completed look. I really liked the way how it turned out. It is a little colorful but wearable at the same time. Now I'm going to finish the rest of my makeup. For that, first I'm taking this Wet n Wild Hot Shady Beaches bronzer and I'm just bronzing up my face to bring back some warmth and color to the face, because that foundation was a little light for me. I need to fix it. For my highlighter, I am taking my Master Chrome highlighter from Maybelline and I'm just applying it on my cheeks, and I completely forgot to apply blush. So here I'm just taking my Maxi blush from Rimmel London and I am applying it on my cheeks, and this is the shade Wildcard. Going back to the highlighter again, I am popping it on my chin, on my cupid bow, down the bridge of my nose, on the center of my forehead. And to set my entire makeup, I am taking my LA Girl setting spray and I'm just setting my entire makeup with it. For my lips, I wanted something with a little bit of red undertone, but not a super duper red shade. And this is the perfect lip combo that I chose. This is my Colourpop Lippy Pencil in the shade Love Bug. I recently shared with you my favorite lip liners from the drugstore video. I will have it linked in the description box down below, so make sure to check it out. For my lipstick, I am using my Walk of No Shame lipstick from Charlotte Tilbury. I am in love with this shade. And here is the completed look. I paired it with silver jewelry. You can definitely go ahead and wear a golden jewelry with it as well. And if you plan to wear a like green outfit, definitely give it a shot. And I absolutely loved the makeup today. And I hope you guys enjoyed watching this video, and I hope this video was helpful for you. If you did, then please hit the like button and please do subscribe to my channel. And if you are not following me on Facebook, Instagram and Twitter, then please do follow me there. All the links will be given in the description box down below, so make sure to check them out. So yes, see you soon in my next video. Till then, bye and take care. Bye.